Hello aspirants, in this lecture we are going to cover the current affairs compilation for the November month 2019. I am Shubhangi Dubey, journalist by profession. So there are so many topics, so I had just selected the few of them, and in this few topics we are going to cover. And the monthly important topics are: the first is online child sexual abuse and exploitation prevention investigation unit, the second is Sisseri River Bridge, the third one is Border Roads Organization, then Health Safety and Dignity of Sanitation Worker Report, then Bali Yatra, then Bhartiya Poshan Krishi Kosh, then Household Consumer Expenditure Survey, then India Skills 2020, then Climate Protection Act and Signal Fish. Other topics are goals of the Curiosity Rover, then Places of Worship Act 1991, then Health System for a New India Building Block Report, then Case Instrument, then Lala Lajpat Rai, then Diesel, then Epilepsy, then Nadu Nedu Scheme, then Asian Defense Minister Meeting Plus, that is ADMM Plus, then Kimberley Process Certification Scheme, that is KPCS, then Injethi Srinivas Committee, then National Mission on Cultural Mapping, NMCM, then Exercise Zahir al-Behr, then Starlink Satellites, then Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandana Yojana, that is PMMVY, then Barents Sea, then Agni 2, third one, other is World Gold Council, then Arundhati Scheme, then End-to-End Inscription Technology, then Mission Parivar Vikas, then SANS Campaign, then Central Drug Standard Control Organization, then Tuberculosis, then Greenhouse Gas Emissions, then Velvet Revolution, Plague, Hong Kong International Convention, then India-Europe 29 Business Forum, and National Action Plan for Drug Demand Reduction. Okay, so these are the major news of the November month, so we are going to cover it. So beginning it with the online child sexual abuse and exploitation prevention investigation unit. Okay, so in this, the Central Bureau of Investigation, they have set up an online child sexual abuse and exploitation prevention investigation unit, and it will also probe the offenses which will be covered under the provision of the Indian Penal Code. Okay, so basically it is for the protection of child for the Sexual Offenses Act and the Information Technology Act, which is apart from the other relevant laws. Okay, so it will function under the agency's special crime zone in Delhi. Okay, so it will be collect and disseminate information on child sexual abuse and the exploitation. The next topic is Sisseri River Bridge. Okay, so Union Defense Minister, it is a short compilation. Okay, so news will be in short, but it will be a revised edition of the November news. Okay, so Union Defense Minister, they have recently inaugurated the import of Sisseri River Bridge at Lower Dibang Valley in Arunachal Pradesh. Okay, so it is an important Sisseri River Bridge. Okay, it is in the Lower Dibang Valley in the Arunachal Pradesh. So it is 200 meter long bridge between the Jonai Pasighat Ranaghat Roing Road, and it will provide the connectivity between Dibang Valley and the Siang. So these are the two valleys which will be the connecting bridge. So keep this in mind, Sisseri River Bridge is the connecting between the Dibang Valley and the Siang, and it is in the state of Arunachal Pradesh. So it will provide connectivity to Tinsukia via Dhola Sadia Bridge. Okay, and it was constructed by the project Brahmank of Border Road Organization. So BRO is the Border Road Organization is the one who have constructed this bridge, and it is also strategically important from a military point of view and will be a part of Trans Arunachal Highway. So for the northeastern states in the state of Arunachal Pradesh, it is strategically important for the military too. The next topic is Border Road Organization. So Border Road Organization, it just maintain and develop the difficult geographical terrain, because Arunachal Pradesh is a state with some difficult terrain, and it is a strategically important area too. So BRO have four projects in Arunachal Pradesh, which is namely Vartak, Arunak, Brahmanak and Udayak. Brahmang it is, Arunang, Brahmang. So Vartak, Arunang, Brahmang and Udayak, these are the four projects of in Arunachal Pradesh by the Border Road Organization, and it mainly contributes to the socio-economic development of the region. So somehow in the socio-economic development of the region, BRO also helps. Then the another topic is Health, Safety and Dignity of Sanitation Workers Report. Okay, so despite the laws and regulations placed in India The practice of manual scavenging is still there. Manual scavenging means that doing all the cleanliness from hand. Okay, so all the human excreta and chambers, you have seen Article 15. There is a moment in which the sweepers are going inside the chambers, and we have heard so many newses too that this number of sweeper died because of the manual scavenging. Okay, so despite the laws and still there is a practice of manual scavenging, it has not been curbed and enforced underground. So basically a report have been jointly authorized by the International Labour Organization, Water Aid, World Bank and the WHO. So these are the four organization who published a joint report. Okay, so how many organization are there? Four organization: World Health Organization, World Bank, Water Aid and International Labour Organization are there. So it is most undesirable and high risk job, obviously, and subcontracted to temporary informal worker despite a sustainable formal permanent sanitation workforce. Even there is a permanent workforce, even technology is being provided, still the practice of manual scavenging is happening. Okay, so somehow there is a report, that means the report highlighted that this should not be done and it should be cured. Okay, then another topic is Bali Yatra. So it was inaugurated in Cuttack on November 12th. So this was about the Bali Yatra, and it is a unique festival in Odisha. Okay, so Bali Yatra is a festival which is in Odisha, and it was inaugurated in Cuttack in Odisha, and it celebrates India's ancient link to Indonesia. Okay, so if the question is there that from which country the Bali Yatra is associated with, so it is the Indonesia. Okay, so it is organized at the bank of river Mahanadi every year from the day of Kartik Purnima according to the Odia calendar. So it is from the Odia calendar, it is organized at the bank of river Mahanadi. Okay, so a UPSC asks such question and there will be the points. Okay, so then we have to select 1, 2, 3 is go right, or 1 or 2 and 2 and 3. So every point is important. Okay, so Cuttack is important point, Odisha is important, links to Indonesia important, bank of river Mahanadi is important. Okay, it is organized in the day of Kartik Purnima according to the Odia calendar. So festival marks the start of journey of hundreds of traders from the states who would set sail to the distinct land of Bali, Sumatra, Java and Indonesia, Borneo and Sri Lanka for the expansion of trade and culture. So Bali Yatra is basically for the sailors. They organized this because somehow in the past also they sailed to the lands of Bali, Sumatra, Java in Indonesia. It is one of the oldest culture and ancient business trade fair practices of the state. So it is an ancient festival which is being celebrated in the India. Okay. Another topic is Bharatiya Poshan Krishi Kosh. Okay, so it is a repository of diverse crop across 128 agroclimatic zones. So there are various 128 agroclimatic zones in India, and Bharatiya Poshan Krishi Kosh has been launched for better nutritional outcomes and to fight malnutrition. So basically it is from the Poshan Krishi Kosh, we can understand it is to combat the malnutrition. Okay, so Ministry of Women and Child Development has done this under this, and in consultation with Ministry of Women and Child Development and Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. Bill Gates, it is a foundation by Bill Gates and its wife. Okay, so Bill Gates, Bill, his wife name is Melinda. Okay, so Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation has helped this, and the project team will select across 12 high focus states. 12 high focus states will be focus there and represented of the geographical, social, economical, cultural and structural diversities of India will be represented. Okay, so there will be a group in each states, and there will be a local partner organization which will make this process. The work process will be like that, and work experience in social and behavioral change, communication will be there, and nutrition for developing the food atlas will be there under the Bharatiya Poshan Krishi Kosh. Okay, another topic is household consumer expenditure survey. So household, it is a survey which was done in 2017 and 18 for over, but it was scrubbed by the government because of the data quality, because of the expected data was not there, so government just scrubbed it. Okay, so it generate the estimates of household monthly per capita consumer expenditure. So how much a consumer is expending in a per capita level, this report was regarding this. Okay, so distribution of household and person over the MPCA classes. So it is designed to collect information regarding expenditure on consumption of goods and services. So basically, how much consumption is being done by the consumers. This was regarding it, and the result after release is also used for rebasing of the GDP. So somehow, with the help of this data, GDP can be understood that how much GDP is there according to the expenditure survey of the households consumers. Okay, so it is by the National Statistical Office, and the Ministry of Statistics and Program Implementation did the survey, and it conducted in quinquennial intervals. Quinquennial intervals are the intervals of 5 years. Okay, so in 5 years such surveys are done again and again. Okay, now the next topic is India Skills 2020. Okay, so India Skills 2020, it is information for skilled and talented youngsters. Okay, so they will be showcasing their abilities at regional and national level competitions, and it will be over 50 skills. Okay, and conducted by the Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship from the India and Skills. We can remember this, that which ministry is going to conduct it, and the age limit is for youth born or after 1st January 1999 with an exemption. Okay, so it is not for the elderly, it is for the young one who is born on or after 1st January 1999. Okay, so it is a biennial competition to scout talent from the country. So whatever skills are there in the 50 different skills, and it will be showcasing at a national and international platforms. So the last India skill competition was organized in 2018. So last year it was organized, wherein 28 states and more than 100 corporate participated. Okay, so this was the participation that gave 355 competitors a chance to display their skills across various skill competitions. Moving on to the next topic, Climate Protection Act. Okay, so this is Protection Act, which was passed from in the German Parliament. Okay, so German Parliament recently passed the Climate Protection Act to reach its climate target by 2050. Okay, so many countries are doing their best according to the Paris Agreement, whatever they have decided. So Germany is one of the best country which is doing good in the climate protection. Okay, so with this, a price on carbon emission in the transport and heat sectors will be imposed, along with some other measures to combat climate change. Okay, so German lawmakers have supported to hike the price of domestic and European flight tickets. So there will be a hike in the price tickets of the domestic and European flight tickets, which will somehow relate to the climate protection. Okay, so from 2021, that means from after 1 year, companies that market diesel and petrol, heating oil and natural gas in the country will need to obtain the pollution rights. So they have to obtain the pollution. It's a very good step by the Germany. Okay, it's an applaudable step, and for the amount of greenhouse gases they emit. Okay, so license will be there, and they have to obtain the pollution right, that how much pollution they are doing for the markets related to diesel and petrol. Okay, then last week New Zealand passed the zero carbon law. So somehow New Zealand is also doing good. They have also passed the last week means in November. Okay, not this last week in December, in November, the last week of the November, in a bid to comply with its Paris Climate Accord commitment and become a carbon neutral nation by the year 2050. So many countries are coming forward to protect the climate in their own level, but India have to do a lot regarding that, because as of now no act have been come in India. The next topic is signal fish. Okay, so India's first signal fish was found in Kerala deep waters. Okay, so India's first signal fish has been found in Kerala, and the discovered species in the world largest signal fish. So species name is the Petroceron indicum, and it was collected by trawlers at a depth of 70 meters during a marine biodiversity survey. So there was a marine biodiversity survey, and in the depth of 70 meters signal fish was seen, and it was found. Okay, so signal fish are spotted in the coral reefs. Coral reefs are very important in the oceans. Okay, it is a very important vegetations in the biodiversity, in the marine biodiversity, and somehow there are so many plans in the worldwide happening to conserve the coral reefs. Okay, so it indicates the presence of patchy coral of the Kerala coast. Okay, so there are patchy coral off in the Kerala coast, and there the signal fish was found. Moving on to the next topic, goal of the Curiosity rover. So, Curiosity rover, it is a NASA's project, and according to the new study, oxygen behaves in a mysterious way on Mars. So, Curiosity is a living robot in the Mars. Okay, and Curiosity's name is Curiosity rover, and it is a NASA's project to understand the things which is whatever happening in Mars. Okay, so. In the new study of Curiosity, there is finding that oxygen behaves in a mysterious way in Mars. Okay, so NASA's Curiosity rover have added a new mystery for scientists who are studying Mars. From a rover showing a seasonal change around oxygen level near the surface of the Gale crater on the red planet. So there is a Gale crater in Mars, and oxygen level is changing according to the seasons. So NASA found that oxygen level throughout spring and summer rose as much as by 30%. So what NASA have found that in the Mars, oxygen level changes in the surface according to the seasons, and it just rose by 30% in spring and the summers. Okay, so according to NASA, Curiosity has four main science goals. Four main science goals are there in support of Mars exploration program. So four goals are there in the Mars exploration program. The first is determine whether life ever across on Mars. Okay, so it is to determine that whether there is a life in Mars. Then characterize the climate of Mars, whatever climate is there, any climate of Mars. Then characterize the geology of Mars. Okay, obviously the geology of Mars will be there. And then prepare for human exploration. So is it okay for human exploration in Mars? Okay, so these are the goals of the Curiosity rover. Then places of worship act 1991. Okay, so this is a interesting topic because you can see that there are places in which anywhere India, there is a hobby of Indian that anywhere they will be making their places to worship in beside a road, in under the tree. Okay, so there is an act which declares that religious character of a place of worship shall continue to be the same as it was on August 15, 1947. Okay, so what the act says, that it says no person shall convert any place of worship or any religious denomination into one of a different denomination or section. Okay, and this is the thing, and declares all suit appeals to proceeding regarding converting the character of a place of worship. So according to the 15th August 1947 Act, place of worship is there. So no legal funding can be instituted if it is in the Act of August 15, 1947. It is not that much important topic. However, there is an exception in the bar of instant fresh proceeding. It is not that many important. So leave the topic. Then another topic is health system for a new India building block report. Okay, so this is an important news. Health system for a new India. So government think tank, which is the Niti Aayog, they have recently released a report, health system for a new India. Okay. And building blocks potential pathway to reforms. Okay, so what report identified? It identified the five focused areas of future health system. The first is to deliver on unfinished public health agenda. Then there is a change health financing away from out of pocket, so spend in large insurers. So there are large insurance amounts are there. Then integrate service delivery vertically and horizontally. So this is about the health system, regarding the health system. Then empower citizens to become better buyers of health, harness the power of digital health. So this is about the report of the health system for a new India. So even as the report has not rightly suggested that Pradhan Mantri Jan Arogya Yojana government cashless covering 10 crore poor family for rupees should be considered with an eye on its potential to influence the overall healthcare transformation in India. So it has not rightly suggested that the Pradhan Mantri Jai, that is Jan Arogya Yojana, which is cashless and helping this number of people, is also exact in the report. Okay, so this is about the health system report by the Niti Aayog. Moving on to the next topic, case instrument. Okay, so what it is? So recently NASA has announced that it will contribute an instrument to a European space mission. That means NASA will help the European space mission, and it will contribute an instrument to explore the atmosphere of planet or exoplanet orbiting stars beyond our sun for the first time. Okay, so for the first time, exoplanet which are orbiting stars beyond our sun, the exploration will be regarding this. Okay, so the instrument will aid the European Space Agency, Ariel, or atmospheric It is the full form of ARIEL is Atmosphere Remote Sensing Infrared Exoplanet Large Survey Mission. So it is our mission to explore the stars beyond our sun, and it is the first of its kind. So NASA instrument had been called the CASE, or Contribution to ARIEL Spectroscopy of Exoplanet, and it will be managed by NASA's Jet Propulsion Laboratory in Pasadena, California. So Pasadena, California, in the Pasadena, California, it will happen, and it will be combining the European Space Mission. So ARIEL spacecraft with CASE on board is expected to launch in 2028. So somehow the CASE, this mission is being started, but it will be expected to launch in 2028. So it is a long period, okay, a period of 9 years will be there. Then the next topic is Lala Lajpat Rai. Okay, so he is known as the firebrand Indian nationalist leader who was affectionately called as Punjab Kesari. So the title of Punjab Kesari was for Lala Lajpat Rai. So he is remembered for his role during the Swadeshi movement and for his advocacy of education. So he was a person who advocated the education a lot, and he did a lot in the Swadeshi movement. So the patriot died at Lahore in 1928. So he died in 1928, and he was attacked by the police during a protest rally against the Simon Commission. So Lala Lajpat Rai died in a rally when they were protesting against the Simon Commission. So there are some important works which were done by the Lala Lajpat Rai. So the Arya Samaj, Young India, England's Debt to India, Evolution of Japan, India's Will to Freedom, Message of the Bhagavad Gita, Political Future of India, Problem of National Education in India, The Depressed Classes, and The Travelogue United States of America are the works which were done by the Lala Lajpat Rai. Okay. Moving on to the next topic, diesel. So recently, first winter grade diesel outlet was inaugurated in Ladakh. So it is a kind of diesel, winter grade diesel. That means that diesel will not be getting freezed even at the lowest temperatures. Okay, so it will boost the tourism, because somehow diesel also get freezed during winters in the normal below the normal temperature. So under the normal condition, the parafex wax added to diesel improve viscosity and the lubrication. So it will improve the viscosity and lubrication in the vehicles, and when temperature begin to fall, the parafex wax thickens and turns into a cloudy mixture. Okay, so this is the paraffin. Paraffin is the wax which thickens and it turns into cloudy mixture, and this is point is known as the fuel cloud point. Okay, so this is about the diesel. So Indian Oil has come up with the innovative solution to this problem. So it is with the problem has solved with the innovative innovation of the Indian Oil. Keep this in mind, by introducing the special winter grade diesel. So winter grade diesel, this is an innovation of the Indian Oil, and with a pour point of 33 degree Celsius, which does not lose its fluidity functions even in extreme winter conditions. So even despite in the extreme winter conditions, this is good. Okay, so the winter grade diesel also meets BIS specification of Bharat Stage 6 grade diesel. Okay, so it is also meeting the condition of BS6 grade diesel. Okay, so this was about diesel. Moving on to the another topic, that is epilepsy. Okay, so in India, November 17th is observed as National Epilepsy Day. So basically, it is to create awareness about the epilepsy. So what it is? It is a chronic non-communicable disease, and which is happens in the brain, and which affects the people of almost all the ages. Okay, so it is seen as a major health problem that was earlier considered to be a mental health disorder. So epilepsy is a kind of mental health disorder, and however, with the advancement in diagnostic and epidemiological studies, epilepsy is now considered a neurological disorder. But now it has been considered as a neurological disorder. So around 50 million people worldwide are suffering from the epilepsy. Okay, and it is making one of the most common neurological disorder globally. So almost 80% of the people with epilepsy live in low and middle income countries, and it is estimated that up to 70% of people living with epilepsy could live seizure free if properly diagnosed and treated. So like it can be treated, it has been said. And in many parts of the world, people with epilepsy and their families suffering from stigma and the discrimination. So somehow, because it is the mental health problem, so people are also suffering from the discriminations in other parts of the world. Okay, Moving on to the next topic, the Nadu Nedu program. So it is a program by the Andhra Pradesh government, okay, and to introduce English medium from class 1st to 6th. So it was somehow also opposed by the people there, because in Andhra Pradesh, Telugu is like they prefer their regional language, okay. So now in the Nedu Nadu program, a scheme will be implemented in 15,750 schools in the first phase, and the budget which has been allotted for the Nadu Nedu program is 12,000 crore. Okay, and it will transform all schools, and required infrastructure will be there, and upgradation of a skill will be there in the English labs, and it will be having the amenities in the schools such as clean environment, furniture should be good, toilets, running water, compound walls, blackboard renovation, and it will also involve the parent committee. Okay, so this is about the Nadu Nedu program, which is in the Andhra Pradesh, for the enhancement of the school education, especially for the English mediums. Okay, then Asian Defense Ministers. Okay, so meeting plus ADMM plus, so it is a guiding principle of open and outward looking, and it happened in Singapore in 2007 and adopted a concept paper to establish the ADMM plus. So it is a defense ministers meeting, so it was held with its 8 dialogue partner. So somehow it will be the strengthening the security and defense cooperation, basically for peace, stability and development in the region. Okay, so there are nations: Brunei, Desalum, Cambodia, Indonesia, Laos, PDR, Malaysia, Myanmar, Philippines, Singapore, Thailand and Vietnam, and 8 plus countries, namely Australia, China, India, Japan, New Zealand, ROK, Russian Federation and the United States are there in the Asian Defense Ministers meeting plus. Okay, so inaugural was convened in Hanoi in Vietnam on 12th October 2010. So before 9 years, the inauguration held in Vietnam's in Hanoi of Vietnam. So defense minister agreed on 5 areas of practical cooperation, and it facilitated cooperation on areas experts working groups established, and in 2013 and 16 new priority areas like humanitarian, mine actions and cyber security, they were agreed respectively. Okay, and Union Minister for Home Affairs recently attended the 6th Asian Defense Minister meeting plus. So this was about the ADMM plus. Moving on to the next topic, Kimberley Process Certification Scheme. Okay, so it is an initiative of government and international diamond industry, including the civil society, to stamp the flow of conflict diamond. Okay, so keep this in mind, Kimberley Process Certification is related to the conflict diamonds. Okay, now what is conflict diamonds? So conflict diamonds are the rough diamonds which are used by the rebel movement or their allies to finance conflict aimed at undermining legitimate government. Okay, so it is also described in the United Nations Security Council resolution. So it is also as according to the aspect of Security Council, conflict diamonds are there. So at present, this scheme has 55 members, which is representing 82 countries, including European Union with 28 members. So 55 members are there. So somehow in the 82 countries, including the European Union, so all the countries which are in the European Union, 28 members from European Union are there. Okay, so this is about the KPCS. Then it is chaired on rotating basis, like on the rotation countries will be participating and they will be chairing, and its vice chair is generally elected by the KP plenary each year, who becomes the chair in the next year. So KP plenary is the one who generally elects the vice chair, and then that person becomes the chair in the next year. India is the current this is important because as of now, India is the chair of Kimberley Process Certification Scheme, with Russian Federation as the vice chair for the year 2019. Okay, so this is the reason this news become important for India. So since 2003, India is actively participating in KPCS process and is a member of all working groups of KP except for WGAAP. Okay, so this is about the, and the Department of Commerce is the nodal department of Gem and Jewelry Export Promotion Council, and it is designed as the KPCS Importing and Exporting Authority in India. Okay, so these are the certifications related to the conflict diamonds. Now, Injethi Srinivas Committee. Okay, so working under the chairmanship of Corporate Affairs Secretary Injethi Srinivas is to further decriminalize the provision of the Company Act 2013. So Srinivas Committee is for the provision. Some of the provisions will be there dismantled, and it is based on the gravity of offenses. So In the Srinivas Injeti Srinivas Committee, the government appointed high-level panel and recently recommended amendments to 46 provisions under the company law, because the time is changing. So Company Act is also changing. Okay, so basically it is to reduce and remove the criminality and declog of the criminal justice system in the Company Act. Okay, because now India is also in the ease of doing business, so then business will be there, more companies will be established, so somehow it is important. So government has earlier thought that Company Act 2019 decriminalizes 16 minor procedural or technical lapses and has categorized them as civil wrongs. Okay, so they are just decriminalized under the Injeti Srinivas Committee. Now another is National Mission on Cultural Mapping. Okay, so it has been set up by the Ministry of Culture before 2 years, in 2017, and the mission will compile data of artists, art forms, geolocations with input of central ministries, state government, and art and culture bodies will be there in the National Mission on Cultural Mapping. So it is a specially designed data capture with technical cooperation of National E-Governance Division. Okay, and it will be based on the data collection. So just keep this in mind, that it will compile the data of artist, art form, and geolocations, and the inputs will be there under the NMCM. The next topic is exercise Zahr al-Bahr. Okay, Zahr al-Bahr meaning roar of the sea. Okay, so it happened at Doha. Okay, and it is a exercise between the navies of India and the Qatar. Okay, so keep this in mind, and it includes the surface action, air defense will be there, maritime surveillance will be there, as a social and sports events will be there under the exercise of Zahr al-Bahr, that means roar of the sea. So it is a bilateral maritime exercise, and it will strengthen the robust defense cooperation between the two countries to fight against terrorism. That will be fighting against the terrorism, maritime piracy, and the security. Okay, another is Starlink satellites. Okay, so Starlink satellites, it is a private project which is launched by the SpaceX. Okay, and it is the world leading private company in the space technology. Okay, so basically there is a spray of 60 Starlink satellites which are fired into orbit. The first operational batch of what is intended with a constellation of nearly 12,000 satellites. So there will be 12,000 satellites, so a combination of a web type structure will be there. Okay, and it will provide low cost and reliable space-based internet services with the help of Starlink satellites. So somehow astronomers are also worrying, because they are too bright, and somehow they can make a mega constellation, and it will create a confusion between the stars and the satellites. So astronomers and scientists have a complaint about the increased light pollution in the space. So somehow this is about the Starlink satellites. Then Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandana Yojana, so it is a maternity scheme which reaches only 1/3 of the beneficiaries. So this is somehow problematic, that this scheme is not going to much of the people. As title, the Jaccha Bachcha Survey, it is a critical which was launched in 2017, and only 1/3 of the beneficiaries got the benefit under this Yojana. Okay, so what it says that RTI data shows only 31% of the eligible mother got benefits. Almost 63% of the pregnant women in rural India work right until the day of the delivery. This is shocking, that more than half of the pregnant women are working in the rural India even in the day of the delivery. Okay, and 49% are exhausted during pregnancy because of the lack of food and rest. Okay, so somehow these are the things which, and what it is target, it only targets women delivering their first child. Okay, so it is not for the second and the third, it is only for the first. And in the scheme, cash amount of ₹6,000 is transferred to the bank account of the beneficiaries in 3 installments upon meeting certain conditions, including early registration of pregnancy, having at least 1 antenatal checkup, and registration of the childbirth. So this was about the Pradhan Mantri Matru Vandana Yojana. Then the Barents Sea. Okay, so what it is, so Barents Sea is because there are crabs. Okay, a species of king crabs are there, and they are not native to Barents Sea, but now they have slowly conquered the region since their introduction. Okay, so this is somehow saying that climate change is happening, and it's easier to fish the crabs. So now Barents Sea is ice free for longer months, and that's why king crabs are there. Okay, so it is classified, now Barents Sea is classified as marginal sea of the Arctic Ocean. Keep this in mind that marginal sea of the Arctic Ocean is the Barents Sea. Okay, so climate changes have led the Barents Sea to having certain characteristic to the Atlantic Ocean. Barents Sea is off of the northern coast of Russia and the Norway. So in the countries Russia and Norway, it is in the northern coast. Okay, so Russian and Norwegian government are involved in border dispute in the Barents Sea. So they are having a border dispute in the Barents Sea. Another is Agni 2. So India has successfully conducted the first night trial of the Agni 2 in November from the Abdul Kalam Island of the Odisha coast. It is a surface-to-surface medium-range nuclear-capable missile, and it is a intermediate-range ballistic missile which have been inducted into the armed forces. So Agni 2 was developed by the Advanced System Laboratory along with the DRDO, and there is an integrated by the Bharat Dynamics Limited. Another topic is World Gold Council. So World Gold Council, it is one of its kind, and gold remained as the third most popular investment because people are investing in shares, and then third most important investment part is of World Gold Council. So 46% of all global retail investors are choosing the gold product. This is huge, and savings account is in 78%, and insurance is in 54%. So this is the, see, these are the criterias. The most is in the saving account, 78%. Then there is 54% in the life insurance, and then 46% is in the global retail investors in gold product. Okay, so it is a market development organization for the gold industry, and its member include the world largest gold mining companies. Okay, so it is based in UK, and its operation is in India, China, Singapore, and the United States, as these countries are the lead gold industries worldwide. Okay, another topic is Arundhati scheme. So it is to check the child marriage. So the scheme has been approved by the Assam government, and it provide 1 tola gold, that is 11.66 gram, to the bride's parent. That means the lady, the one who is bride, their parents will be getting under the Arundhati scheme. And to check child marriage, the scheme has said that it will be only when the girl in India will be above the age of 18 years. Okay, and boy will be in the 21 years. So if a girl is getting marriage after the age of 18 years, only then the scheme will be implemented. Okay, so it is limited to the weaker section of the society, whose annual income is below rupees 5 lakh, irrespective of the caste, creed, religion, etc. Okay, so this was about the Arundhati scheme. Another is end-to-end inscription technology. In WhatsApp, we have already seen there is an end-to-end inscription is there. So basically, it is a message which can be deciphered only by the sender. Okay, no other person can access to that. Okay, and it is encrypted in the sender's device, and once it is sent, only with the help of cryptogenic keys that can be generated, otherwise nobody can say. So with the help of example, it is a locked mailbox. Locked mailboxes, anybody can drop the mail in it, but only you can access to that box because you are having the key. You are having the private key to unlock it, and it is the end-to-end inscription technology. Then Mission Parivar Vikas is there. So Mission Parivar Vikas, it was launched by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, and almost 145 high focus districts have been there, which are having the highest total fertility rates across the country. So there are 145 districts which is having the highest fertility rate, and under this there are states Uttar Pradesh, Bihar, Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Jharkhand, and Assam. So these are the states in which is having 44% of the country's population. Okay, so major objective of Mission Parivar Vikas is to have the access to high quality family planning, which will be in information based, reliable service based, and supply of right based framework. Okay, so 145 districts have been highly focused, which will be having the Mission Parivar Vikas. Okay, so they have been identified in total fertility rate and service, and for immediate spatial and accelerated efforts to reach the replacement level fertility goals of 2.1 by 2025. So somehow there will be having some sterilization programs under the Mission Parivar Vikas. another topic is SANS campaign. So SANS campaign is for the social awareness and action to neutralize pneumonia successfully. So basically it is for the pneumonia and it is to reduce child mortality due to pneumonia. So children are getting affected because of the pneumonia, and it is said that around 15% death annually is happening because of the pneumonia for the children which are under the age of 5 years. Okay, so the campaign was launched in Gandhinagar, Gujarat, and the 6th national summit on good replicable practice and innovations was there in the SANS campaign. So keep this in mind, it is for the pneumonia. Okay, so somehow it will be checked that less number of children should be get it from the pneumonia. Moving on to the next topic, Central Drug Standard Control Organization. So it is a regulatory body which works under the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, and somehow it is to check the drug usage in the pharmaceuticals and medical devices in India. Okay, so what are its major functions? So its major functions are control over the import of drugs, then approval of new drugs and clinical trials, approval will be there, then meeting of drugs consultative committee, then drug technical advisory board will be there under its function. Okay, so there are 6 zonal offices of CDSCO, 13 port offices are there with 7 laboratories under its control. Okay, so they provide license, approval of licenses there under the Central Licensing Approving Authority, which is approved by this CDSCO headquarters. The next topic is tuberculosis. Okay, so there is a national strategic plan which says that by year 2025 tuberculosis should be end, which was started in year 2017. Okay, so India target is to eliminate the tuberculosis by 2025, and it is 5 years ahead of the global target of 2030. So in the world level, that global target of tuberculosis, eradicating the tuberculosis, 2030, but India have to eradicate and eliminate the tuberculosis by 2025. So Nikshay, it is a enabled patient management system. Ni means end, and Kshay means TB. Okay, so it is Nikshay, and then it is for TB control under the revised National Tuberculosis Program. Already it is being developed and maintained by the Central TB Divisions, Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. So it is with the National Informatics Center is going to help it. Okay, so keep this in mind, that tuberculosis sub-target of India is 2025. Moving on to the next topic, greenhouse gas emission. Okay, so it is because there was a research which was done by the University of Cambridge and the United Kingdom, that every drop of fresh water contains thousands of different organic molecules that have previously gone unnoticed. Okay, so this was about, so a study says that climate change may cause the level of greenhouse gas emitted by fresh water lakes to increase by between 1.5 to 2.7 times. So this is somehow this saying that because of the fresh water, the level of greenhouse emission can be raised, it can be increased by the fresh water lakes. Okay, so fresh water ecosystem, it is a small fraction, it is not that much in our planet. Okay, so amount of carbon in the inland water it emits covered by the living organism on earth, and so this is not that much important. Greenhouse gas emission is because of the fresh water lake, it is simply as that. Okay, moving on to the next topic, Velvet Revolution. So with the so-called Velvet Revolution of 1989, Czechoslovakia freed itself of communist control and set out to adopt its command economy to the free market. Okay, so Velvet Revolution, it is economic. So it 30th anniversary, because of the 30th anniversary of Velvet Revolution, this was there, and it is for the a program which is based on the policies of price liberalization. Okay, so price will be like there will be liberalization, and opening of market to foreign trade and investment will be there in the Velvet Revolution. Moving on to the next topic, plague. Okay, so it is pneumonic plague and bubonic plague. These are the types of plagues which is caused by the Yersinia pestis bacterium. Okay, so this is the bacteria name plague, and bites from infected fleas are most common cause of bubonic plague infections. Okay, so infected fleas are there, because of which bubonic plague infections happens, and it is a pneumonic variant. So the bacteria is the pneumonic plague is because of the Yersinia pestis bacterium. So it is a third variant of the disease septicesium plague, which infects the blood stream. Okay, so keep this in mind about the bacterium and the third rare variant of the disease. Then Hong Kong International Convention. So IMO, it adopted the Hong Kong International Convention for the safe and environmentally sound recycling of ships. So basically it is International Convention for the recycling of ships, which began in 2009. So it will help India. So ship recycling capacity will increase in India over the next 5 years. Okay, so recently cabinet has approved the proposal of recycling of ship bill, which was introduced in 2019. And recycling of ship, you can understand that INS Vikrant was there, and then the motorbike came. So somehow it was like the Vikrant name was given because all the iron which was in the Vikrant was used in those bikes. Okay, so it is like that. Okay, India is leader in the global ship recycling industry. So somehow India is already leader in the global ship recycling, and it is having a share of over 30% in the market. So keep this in mind that Hong Kong International Convention is related to the recycling of ship, which began in 2009, but recently a bill passed in India. Okay, and now it is to have the doubling the recycling of ship over the next 5 years. Then India Europe 29 Business Forum. So it has recently organized the Ministry of External Affairs, and it is by the Government of India with the Confederation of the Indian Industry. So 29 Europe regions refers to 29 countries in Central, Eastern and Northern European. So 29 countries are there in these, and it is a business forum, and which it will be acting as a bridge. Okay, geographical and knowledge gap, it will somehow help in maintaining the geographical and knowledge gap. It will fulfill the geographical and knowledge gap between the two regions. Okay, so how many Europe 29 regions are there? So Albania, Liechtenstein, Austria, Lithuania, Bosnia, Herzegovina, Macedonia, Bulgaria, Malta, Croatia, Moldova, Cyprus, Montenegro, Czech Republic, Norway, Denmark, Poland, Estonia, Romania, Finland, Serbia, Greece, Slovak Republic, Hungary, Slovenia, Iceland, Sweden, Latvia, Switzerland and Turkey. These are the 20 European which will be based with the India Europe 29 Business Forum. Moving on to the next topic, National Action Plan for Drug Demand Reduction. Okay, so it is a drug demand reduction, NADPR, which has been prepared for 2018 till 2023, and it is drafted by the Ministry of Social Justice and the Empowerment. Okay, so it is aiming to reduce the adverse consequences of drugs. Okay, and it involves the education, de-addiction and rehabilitation of the drugs in the affected families. So whatever affected individual are there, they are going to help it. Then IMD World Talent Ranking. So India has slipped 6 places to 59 on its global annual list of 63 countries. Okay, so this is the IMD World Ranking. It has been released by the International Institute for Management Development. So IMD had released it, IMD, that is International Institute for Management Development. So ranking is based on the performance on 3 categories, that is investment and development, appeal and readiness. So this is about the IMD World Talent Ranking 2019. Okay, the next is National Institute of Social Defense, NISD. So it is in New Delhi. It is an autonomous under the administrative control of the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment. It is a nodal training agency, and it covers the entire gamut of activities and program for the protection of society. So these are there in the National Institute of Social Defense, and it is a program. And in the area of drug abuse prevention, welfare of senior citizens, beggary prevention is there under the... See, social defense is a thing which is related to the drug abuse prevention, welfare of senior citizens, beggary prevention, transgender and other social defense issues. Okay, so social defense means like defending society from certain things. So guys, this was the current affairs compilation of November 2019. Okay, so we have covered almost more than 30 to 35 important major news, and we ended it with the National Institute of the Social Defense. So this was the lecture, and we will come up with the compilation of December too. Thanks for watching.